Emirates operates flight 231 from Dubai to Washington Dulles daily, serviced since December by Boeing 777-300ER aircraft. At 2:52 a.m. on Monday, December 20 local time, Alpha 6 Echo Quebec India pushed back from gate Foxtrot 25 and taxied to the threshold of Dubai's runway 30 right. At 3:09, the aircraft lined up on the runway, ready for departure. The crew powered up the engines and began their takeoff roll. As the aircraft accelerated down the runway, it deviated from its expected profile. The aircraft's transponder reported that the aircraft was still on the ground past the displaced threshold, on the runway end safety area, traveling at 216 knots. This is well above the expected speed for the aircraft to begin its takeoff rotation. The following two reports show the aircraft flying at 75 feet, then 175 feet over the streets of Dubai, at 1.7 kilometers and 3.1 kilometers past the threshold of runway 12 left, respectively. During this time, the aircraft accelerated through 247 knots indicated airspeed, well above the published speed restriction of max 220 knots for this section of the Senpa 2 Foxtrot departure. For comparison, at this distance from the airport, 777s departing from runway 30 right are usually climbing through 1500 feet. At this point, a crew member realized there was a problem, and the aircraft initiated a steep climb to get the speed under control, then turned back towards the assigned departure routing. The remainder of the flight continued uneventfully, and the aircraft arrived normally into Washington after 14 hours and 21 minutes in the air. The aircraft was checked for cracks, as well as damage to the wings, flaps, and landing gear. One source reported that the aircraft sustained some damage during the departure, however this was not confirmed. The aircraft operated a return service to Dubai, and was thereafter grounded for several days. On December 27, Emirates released the following crew alert for their pilots. Company NOTAM, B777 MCP power-up defaults and after-landing-slash-shutdown MCP changes. Crews are reminded that there are no FCOM normal procedure requirements to change the MCP after landing or shutdown. There have been times when the MCP altitude window has been set to the airport elevation, which may cause issues on the subsequent departure. The FCOM states that the AFDS will engage in ALT when the first flight director switch is turned on, if the MCP selected altitude is within 20 feet of the displayed barrow altitude. Crews shall not set airport elevation on the MCP after landing or shutdown. Emirates has confirmed that the incident is under investigation and would not provide any further comment. The crew alert and the aircraft's irregular climb profile has led some experts to assert the following as a potential series of events. Let's get our 5-point harnesses on and discuss further on the flight deck. Alright, so here we are on the flight deck. It's about 1:30 local time, the aircraft is parked at gate Foxtrot 25, and the passengers are checking in. The aircraft was secured by the previous crew at the end of the previous flight from Zurich, and is currently connected to ground power. I'm going to go ahead and complete the pre-flight setup, then we'll run the before start checklist. Before start checklist. Flight deck door, closed and locked. MCP, V2-183, heading 300, altitude 4000. Takeoff speeds, V1-168, rotate 177, V2-183. CDU pre-flight, completed. Trim, 6.2 units, 0 and 0. Taxi and takeoff briefing, completed. Before start checklist, complete. Alright, let's push back and I'll see you at runway 30 right.
Emirates 231, wind 180 at 2 knots, runway 30 right, clear for takeoff.
Emirates 231, clear for takeoff, 30 right. Takeoff. Thrust stable. Toga. Takeoff thrust set. Eighty knots. That unfolded quite quickly. Let's rewind and take another look at what happened. As we accelerate down the runway, note that the Autopilot Flight Director System, or AFDS, pitch mode is showing out rather than toga, which is the usual mode during the takeoff roll. In the toga mode, the Flight Director Primary Flight Display, PFD, pitch bar indicates an initial pitch of 8 degrees up. Toga pitch guidance becomes active at liftoff. After liftoff, the AFDS commands a pitch attitude to maintain a target speed of V2 plus 15 knots or the airspeed at rotation plus 15 knots, whichever is greater. In altitude hold mode, the AFDS commands pitch to maintain the altitude when the switch was pressed or the mode was engaged. With the altitude hold mode engaged on the ground, the flight director commands a pitch to maintain 0 feet, including after liftoff. The Boeing 777 amplified procedures explain how to rotate the aircraft as follows. The pilot monitoring calls rotate, and the pilot flying rotates towards 15 degrees pitch attitude, follows the flight director's commands, and establishes a positive rate of climb. It appears that the pilot flying in this case initially followed the flight director's pitch commands, even though it was not commanding the expected pitch attitude and a positive rate of climb was not established. This resulted in the aircraft remaining on the ground past the expected rotation point and the following lack of climb out. Note that the auto throttle remains in hold mode, commanding takeoff thrust. Without the expected rate of climb, this results in a rapid acceleration, exceeding the departure's speed limit. After about 25 seconds, the crew determine that the flight director is commanding an inappropriate attitude, and they put the aircraft into a steep climb to bleed off some airspeed. From here, the flight continues normally. Why was the AFDS pitch mode selected to altitude hold? At this stage, we don't know. Based on the crew alert disseminated after the incident, and with reference to the Boeing 777 Flight Crew Operations Manual, we can speculate that something like the following may have occurred. After the previous crew concluded their flight, they set the altitude window to 0 feet. As the crew alert states, this is not part of the shutdown or secure procedure. Why they did this is unknown. When the incident crew arrives, the flight director switches are selected on, with the altitude window still showing 0 feet. As per the FCOM, the first flight director switch engages the flight director in altitude pitch mode when selected altitude is within 20 feet of displayed barometric altitude. If alt mode engages, selecting an altitude more than 20 feet from the displayed barometric altitude and recycling the first switch arms the flight director in toga roll and pitch modes. Because the selected altitude is within 20 feet of the aircraft's current altitude, altitude hold mode engages. Part of Boeing's recommended pre-flight procedure is for both pilots to independently verify that the flight mode enunciations are correct. Auto throttle mode is blank, roll mode is toga, pitch mode is toga, AFDS status is flight director. No one on the flight deck notices the incorrectly engaged altitude hold mode during the pre-flight, taxi, or takeoff roll. When the crew receives their departure clearance, they enter their cleared altitude into the altitude window on the MCP. However, because they don't recycle the flight director switches, altitude hold mode remains engaged. During the pre-flight procedure, the captain should set up the MCP. Set V2 on the IAS mark selector, arm LNAV and VNAV as needed, and set the initial heading and altitude. The FCOM states, announcing changes on the FMA and thrust mode display when they occur is a good CRM practice. It seems that the captain did not announce that LNAV and VNAV were armed, nor did they check the FMA status. Otherwise, they may have spotted the incorrect pitch mode. Nor during the taxi and takeoff briefing did anyone on the flight deck notice the selected pitch mode FMA. When commencing the takeoff roll, pushing a toga switch activates the auto throttle in the thrust reference mode below 50 knots indicated airspeed. At 80 knots, the auto throttle mode enunciation changes to hold. The pilot monitoring's attention should have been brought to the flight mode enunciators, but again, they did not spot the erroneous pitch mode. The investigation is in its early stages and will likely take many months to complete. I hope that this deep dive has provided you with additional understanding of the 777 and its system and how this incident unfolded. If you liked this, don't forget to leave a comment or like the video, or visit the Air Traffic Visualized Patreon page if you'd like to support more videos like this.